Well, did you hear about this one? Protesters are crying out, ban the box. Washington, D.C. could be the next city to prohibit companies and small businesses from having job applicants check a box on their job application if they have criminal records. Attorney Judy Albanese believes companies should be allowed to perform background checks like this, but Whitney Bowen disagrees. Now, Whitney, why do you think this is wrong?
I think this is wrong as far as the boxes on these applications, because it's only giving employers a picture that is no more than what it is, a box with a check on it. It doesn't give anyone the opportunity to be viewed as a person, to be interviewed, to be assessed to see if they're the right person for that job. It's hurting employers too, because it's depriving them of the opportunity to find the best candidates for the job.
Judy, what do you think?
I would argue that the employee has an absolute right as well as a duty to have a potential employee.
An employer has a right and a duty, right?
Right, to have the employee answer the question. Just because you check the box doesn't mean that the person won't get hired. Just by way of example, if you have a gentleman who's 25 years old, he's graduated college, he's passed his CPA exam, and he was arrested at the age of 18 for getting in a fight, that's most likely not relevant to his employment. However, you take the other extreme, and that would be a truck driver who's been convicted of vehicular manslaughter, and he's applying for a driving position. Well, that could be a danger to the public at large, and also
or a security guard who robbed a bank or something like that, or somebody who committed credit card fraud and they're dealing with credit cards.
You know, absolutely.
Whitney, I mean, I think, you know, small businesses want to be humanitarian. They want to, you know, help out employees, but don't they have a right to know who their employees are and what their backgrounds are?
Absolutely, they have a right to know. But the issue here is that people are getting excluded for consideration for jobs simply because of a box. And that's not the right thing. It's not helping these employers either that they're not getting the full picture of who this person is. This isn't Mayberry. The days of Andy Griffith are over, and they're long gone.
But why have the government tell the small business what to do and basically federalize it, or, you know, criminalize the small business, saying, you know what, you small business, you can't delve further at the get-go. You have to wait and into the job application process before you ask about the criminal background of an applicant. Is that right?
I think that it is right. I think that it's helping these small business owners because it's giving them the opportunity to be able to see people as employees
quickly
that are appropriate for the job and what they've
Judy,
got
quickly
to offer as opposed to what's in a box.
The Equal Employment Opportunity Commission has recently updated its guidelines from 1990, and they indicate it's to be decided on a case-by-case basis, and they use three factors within which to determine
it. We can't really go into that, but you're saying that basically
the guidelines are there's factors to consider.
Okay, all right. Next up, could Malaysia Airlines be held liable for yesterday's crash? According to data from an aviation firm, global flights are now avoiding Ukrainian airspace. This, as Malaysia's transport minister has had approved the route, saying it was safe. Judy, do you think Malaysia Airlines could be responsible for this?
I absolutely do. I believe that Malaysia Airlines and the Malaysian government are partially responsible for the death of 298 individuals.
Do you think they could be sued?
Yes, I do. They had prior notice of the turmoil and violence in that area. In 2014, the United States, the FAA, issued a no-fly zone because it was so dangerous.
Okay.
They had an obligation to protect their passengers, and they avoided that duty. They
I hear what you're saying. Whitney, what do you think?
I think I completely 100% disagree. The only people that are responsible for what happened in this incident that is an absolute tragedy are the people who fired that rocket or that missile and the people that are backing them, whether it be Russia, whether it be they're their own separatist thing, as people suspect, whatever that may be. The bottom line is Malaysia is not responsible for something where they were operating like other commercial airline operators and they're flying at 33,000 feet.
You're saying
there were
quickly
two Ukrainian military flights shot down within the past 2 days. These are civilians. They should be protecting
those were low flying planes. Those were low flying planes. Those were not planes that were flying at the altitude that this plane was flying at. Which
it doesn't
again,
matter.
Multiple
you have an obligation to protect
at that altitude
your passengers and your citizens.
Okay, we got to leave it there. Boy, you gals really mix it up. You're terrific.